Curtis Granderson, graduated from the University of Illinois Chicago, currently playing center field for the New York Yankees.
Baseball has a season, but being Curtis Granderson does not. He works just as hard, if not harder, in the offseason. He's the ambassador of baseball, speaking on behalf of the Olympic Committee. He's won the Roberto Clemente Award, the Marvin Miller Award, which is voted by his peers. He grew up in Chicago, so he knows that there were a lot of kids who didn't have an opportunity being in the inner city, so he really tries to give back and make sure that they get every chance to succeed.
The reason why I chose to go to University of Illinois Chicago, they were gonna give me the opportunity to play both baseball and basketball. My college experience was great. It put me in a very diverse group of people. All the student athletes there, we had to do food drives, and we're getting all this food together and we're delivering it throughout the city of Chicago, pulling up at people's houses and seeing the reaction on their faces, knowing that they're gonna get a good meal for the holiday. Being around my parents early on, I saw how they were with people, how they were always trying to help people out, whatever it happened to be, and it wasn't always monetary. You need a ride? We're gonna pick you up on the way here. You need some clothes? I grew out of them, here you go. You need help moving in and out of your house? What day, what time, let us know. That was just the way I was brought up. Both my parents are recently retired educators, and they instilled right away that, hey, the school level to qualify to play is at this, but we need you to just get a little bit higher. We don't need straight A's. We just need you to go ahead and do what we think you're capable of doing. I think the big motivation to give back is what helped you get to where you are today. The charity foundation aspect came to me in saying, hey, do you want to go ahead and give back to the community? I said, of course. For me, in order for me to make it what it was, I had to do something I was passionate about, education. The first question was, well, what do you want to do with education? I just want to show the importance of it, especially when I was in Detroit where my career was established. The dropout rate was increasing, the illiteracy rate was rising. I felt that, hey, this is the best spot to go ahead and show the importance of education. Being a minority, a lot of people could kind of relate to me. Coming from Chicago, very similar city to Detroit, I thought a lot of parallels were right there. So I established the Grandkids Foundation, which dealt with inner city education, but I obviously couldn't forget why I was able to do this is the baseball component, and obviously showing the importance of bringing back baseball in the inner cities as well. It's cool getting a chance to be an African-American, playing baseball at the highest level, showing that, hey, if I can do it, you definitely can do it. So I think that goes ahead and opens their eyes up a little bit more. I get an opportunity to wear different shoes, batting glove, and fielding glove, and financially get compensated for doing it. I don't necessarily need that financial reward from those companies. So I said, can I get that same amount of monetary value in product? So I can go ahead and donate it out to those less fortunate that may want to play this great game of baseball but can't afford it.
He doesn't view himself differently than anyone else. He just happens to be able to play for the New York Yankees. But at the end of the day, he's just a nice guy who loves talking to people, and people love him. And it's great to work with a guy like that.
Always continue to set the bar high and keep going and keep going. We're teammates both on the field and off the field. Well, thank you very much for allowing me a little bit of time.